Hello, and welcome. As many of you have requested, today we'll have a video about setting up and explaining the main functions of lossless scaling. This type of video often faces monetization restrictions and sometimes gets deleted, so I'll also leave the video link on Patreon. Don't worry, you can access it for free whenever you want. I'll also leave two other videos in the description and pinned comment for you to see more tests and details about LS. Without further ado, let's get to the program presentation. First, the program needs a small configuration to improve its functionality. After purchasing it on Steam, you should open it for the first time and click on Settings. Check the following options for better performance. Start as administrator. You can already configure the scale hotkey field, as it is much easier and avoids many problems if you activate the program directly from a shortcut key. Sometimes, some games simply crash when minimized with LS active. After this configuration, you should close the program and run it again through Steam, granting administrator permission. After this new execution, I'll give a brief explanation of the features. In the scaling type field, you'll find various scaling options, from AMD FSR, NVIDIA NIS, to even a filter for scaling anime to a higher frame rate without losing details. Yes, you can use LS to increase the FPS of your anime and movies as well. If you're already playing in native 1080p and only want to increase the frame rate of games, I recommend leaving this option off. And now we come to the most important step, the frame generator. By default, frame generation should be off. Here we have two options, LSFG 1.1 and LSFG 2.1. LSFG 1.1 has lower frame generation and a simpler algorithm, causing more artifacts and delivering a lower frame rate. However, this algorithm is very light, ideal for PCs with more modest GPUs or integrated GPUs. LSFG 2.1 offers the highest quality so far, at the cost of about 30% more GPU load. Version 2.1 is recommended for most users with reasonably modern hardware, presenting only minor graphic artifacts at the edges, while the interface and other HUD elements are hardly affected. Another very important option is the operating mode of LSFR. When using the 2x mode, for each real frame rendered by your GPU, LSFR will generate a new frame, thus doubling your performance. For example, if you have a performance of 50 FPS, you will get 100 FPS. This option generates lower latency and a lower GPU load. The 3x option is capable of generating 2 interpolated frames per real frame rendered by your GPU. Therefore, if you have a real performance of 60 FPS, enabling this option will result in 180 FPS. Remember, it's ideal to have a static FPS. For 1080p resolution, the minimum recommended is 30 FPS. Variable FPS can hinder LSFR's performance, so if you intend to use LSFR, lock the game's FPS through the graphics menu or use RevTuner, for example. More details about this option are available in the videos in the description. The performance mode allows for a higher frame rate for more modest GPUs, at the cost of more graphic artifacts. It can be used if, when activating LS, your PC shows a GPU bottleneck. Remember that LS makes intensive use of the GPU and little use of the CPU. Beyond these, there aren't many other options to explore. There is a VSync option, but when using LSFR 2.1, the system already prevents frame generation above your screen's refresh rate. HDR support, which I tested, unfortunately leaves the experience of HDR-compatible games with washed-out and unattractive colors. The allow tearing option can significantly reduce input delay for those who have issues with it. In my case, I don't have issues except in RPC S3, where I do feel some delay that, depending on the game, can be disruptive. Draw FPS allows you to see how many FPS LSFR is generating, a good option to always keep enabled. In Capture API, always prefer DXGI. Practically any GPU from the last 10 years supports DXGI, which allows for a higher number of frames generated and reduces artifacts compared to other available options. If you have an active integrated GPU or more than one GPU installed in the system, select the most powerful GPU and preferred GPU to avoid low performance issues in both the games and LS. Finally, I'll leave some presets for you, using both the X2 and X3 modes, based on better graphic quality and better performance. I'll also include a mode for those with a really low-end PC, where maximum performance is focused on, without worrying about graphic artifacts. Find the ideal configuration for you, pause the video, and set it up accordingly. The other options can be completely ignored. Your application is now configured. Next, I will show various tips and tests in emulators. Before some basic tests, if you enjoy content related to lossless scaling and want to see more of this type of content on the channel, don't forget to like this video to help with its promotion. And if this is your first time here, consider subscribing to the channel. First, in PCSX2, I used the game Gran Turismo 4, running at 1080p with fixed 60fps, which is the limit of this game without any modification. As I mentioned in my last video, there are some PlayStation 2 games that use a technique of duplicating all even frames to save performance, which can make the LS experience less pleasant. So, I recommend using LS only in games that natively run at 60fps or 50fps in their European versions. Since it's not yet possible to record the generated frames, I left a marker on the screen so you can see the performance I achieved. Impressively, I managed to keep the game almost entirely at 180fps, with very smooth movements and no input delay issues. Before we start in our PCS3, here's a tip. If LS is not interpolating correctly in this emulator, leave our PCS3 in windowed mode and then use the command to start interpolation in our PCS3. This will make LS work correctly, as it doesn't always work in full screen mode in our PCS3. In our PCS3, we ran two tests. The first was in God of War 3, which is a game you can play from start to finish, depending on your processor, with the frame rate locked at 30 so that LS can work in the best possible scenario. In areas with the most enemies, even if the FPS varies by 1 or 2, the results generated by LS get very close to 90fps. The sense of fluidity is excellent, and as I always say, sometimes I feel a bit of input delay in RPCS3. However, in this test, I didn't notice any delay, as can be seen now in the background, executing the QuickTime events without issues of unresponsive commands. In more closed environments, we get even more fluidity, maintaining 90fps of interpolated frames without changes to the game. Finally, the second test was with Gran Turismo 6, which performs poorly on my PC, rarely maintaining 30fps. I ran this test to show that, even with LS managing to generate close to 60fps, the overall quality is poor, and the input delay here is a severe issue. Therefore, if you cannot maintain a stable frame rate of at least 30fps, the experience will not be good. There are no miracles. However, if a game can maintain 30fps, as was the case with God of War, the experience will be very pleasant. We all know that running these Sony exclusives on RPCS3 with a high frame rate will require a top-notch processor. Finally, let's push LS to the limit on Sadachi using the game Bayonetta 3. As you can see, I will be using a 900p and 60fps mod. Natively, the game runs at 30fps and 480p in handheld mode or 800p in docked mode. Besides using the 900p mod, I will be doubling my resolution to run the game at a true 1800p. As you can see next, even with huge enemies on the screen, it was easily possible to run the game at 180fps. If you're wondering about input delay, it's practically non-existent. Anyone who has played Bayonetta knows that executing Witch Hour, where everything goes into slow motion, requires almost perfect timing. I was able to execute it multiple times during the gameplay. And that was the video, folks. If you want more LS tests, leave your suggestions in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.